Hello friends, today we are going to learn matter in our surroundings. Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. On the basis of the physical state, matter is classified as solids, liquids, and gases. On the basis of chemical composition, matter can be classified as few substances and mixtures. Few substances are either elements or compounds. Mixtures may be homogeneous mixtures or heterogeneous mixtures. Particulate nature of matter. Particulate nature means that matter is made up of very small particles. These particles are either atom, molecule, or ion. Following properties are associated with particulate nature of matter. The particles of matter have space between them. The particles of matter are continuously moving. The particles of matter attract each other. States of matter. Matter exists in three different states, which are solid, liquids, and gases. Properties of solids. Solids have a definite shape and volume. The space between the particles is minimum. The force of attraction between the particles is maximum. The movement of the particles is minimum. They are least compressible. Their rate of diffusion is least. Properties of liquids. Liquids have no definite shape but have fixed volume. Liquids take the shape of the container. The space between the particles is more than solids and less than gases. The forces of attraction between the particles is less than solids and more than gases. The movement of the particles is intermediate. Properties of gases. Gases have no definite shape or fixed volume. Gases occupy the whole space of the container. The space between the particles is maximum. The force of attraction between the particles is minimum. The movement of the particles is maximum. They are most compressible. Their rate of diffusion is more than solids and liquids. Studying melting point. When a solid is heated, particles begin to vibrate and move more freely. Then at a fixed temperature, the solid into liquid. This process is called melting or fusion. The temperature at which a solid melts is called its melting point. The melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius. Latent heat of fusion. The amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of a solid into liquid at atmospheric pressure at its melting point is called the latent heat of fusion. When we measure melting points, the tip of thermometer must be placed in water enclosed between ice particles. This ensures that melting point of state with high kinetic energy is observed. Studying boiling point. When a liquid is heated, its particles begin to move faster and at a particular temperature, liquid begins to boil and changes into gas. Boiling is a bulk phenomenon as entire volume of liquid boils at once and changes into vapor. The temperature at which a liquid starts boiling is called its boiling point. The boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. Latent heat of vaporization. The amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of a liquid into gas at atmospheric pressure and its boiling point is called the latent heat of vaporization. When we measure boiling point, the tip of thermometer must be placed just above surface of boiling water. Effect of pressure on gases. When pressure is applied on gas, the particles come close, which increases the interparticle forces and the gas changes into liquid. Hence, we can liquefy gas by applying pressure and decreasing the temperature. Compressed solid carbon dioxide is called dry ice. If the pressure is reduced, it changes directly to gas without coming into liquid state. So, solid carbon dioxide is known as dry ice. Interconversion of the three states of matter. The state of matter can be changed by changing the temperature or pressure. Separation techniques. These techniques are used to separate components of mixtures on basis of variation in physical properties like boiling point, melting point, solubility, etc. Sublimation. The change of state directly from solid to gas or from gas to solid is called sublimation. Example, if solid camphor or ammonium chloride is heated, it changes into vapor. If the vapor is cooled, it changes into solid. Evaporation. The change of a liquid into vapor at any temperature below its boiling point is called evaporation. Evaporation is a surface phenomenon. Particles at the surface of liquid absorb enough energy to overcome the forces of attraction, latent heat of vaporization, and it changes to vapor state. Factors affecting evaporation. The rate of evaporation depends upon surface area, temperature, humidity, and wind speed. Increase in the surface area increases the rate of evaporation. Increase in temperature increases the rate of evaporation. Increase in humidity decreases the rate of evaporation. Increase in wind speed increases the rate of evaporation. Evaporation and its cooling effects. When a liquid evaporates, the particles of the liquid absorb heat from the surroundings and evaporates. As a result, the surroundings become cold. Example, people sprinkle water on the roof or open ground because during evaporation, water absorbs heat from surface, which make the hot surface cool. During summer, we perspire more as sweat absorbs heat from our body, making the body cool. Wearing cotton clothes in summer keeps us cool because cotton absorbs sweat, and when the sweat evaporates, it absorbs heat from our body, thus making the body cool. Desert cooler works better on a hot and dry day, as evaporation is more in such conditions.